So everybody's talking about tomorrow's wedding, about Prince Harry's and Meghan Markle's wedding. And I got inspired too. And today I'm going to tell you how Royal British wedding differs from traditional Latvian wedding. Hi, my name is Ilze Be and I teach Latvian to English speakers. When we talk about weddings, there are three Latvian words that we can use. First is kāzas, second is precības, and the third one is laulības. And I'll talk about the first word first. So it was kāzas. What you need to remember is you have to make sure that you pronounce it with a long vowel a, kāzas. Once more, kāzas, because kāzas with the short a means goats, so you don't want to say that. And kāzas means wedding. That's the ceremony or the party after the ceremony. And the other word, precības, also means wedding, but not only. It's also the time when you negotiate, when you plan the wedding, who is going to do what and who is going to pay for what. And this word is actually derived from the word prece. Prece means a commodity or an article that is put out on the market for sale. So prece would be the root of the word and e is the ending prece if we talk about that item for sale. But precības is that word where ancient Latvians, when there were two families where they negotiated, they wanted to know who can bring what into the marriage. So the word, once more, was precības. Precības. This word is not that commonly used anymore. However, another word that has also been derived from the word prece, namely the word precējies or neprecējies, means married or single or unmarried, so to say. And this word applies only to males. Once more, precējies, precējies. However, when we talk about females or we want to declare our family status, we would say precējusies or neprecējusies. Once more, precējusies, and that would mean married, and neprecējusies would mean single or literally unmarried. And there was the third word, laulība. Laulība actually means marriage. That is not really the wedding, that's the life after the wedding, living together. However, in Latvia, a word combination, laulību, ceremony, is often used to mean wedding. So once more, when we say wedding in Latvian, we can say it in three ways. We can say kāzas or precības or laulību ceremonija. But moving on, there was that drama around Meghan Markle's dad. Everybody was wondering whether or not he would come to the wedding and walk Meghan down the aisle. Well, if it was in Latvia, it wouldn't be a big problem, because in Latvia, walking somebody down the aisle is not a typical tradition. How it happens typically in Latvia, there is an older couple, a married couple, who supposedly have to be role models for the newlyweds or for the bride and the groom. So when they walk down the aisle, the married couple walks first. So those two people, the married woman and the married man, would walk in front of the bride and the groom, and all four together they would walk down the aisle and everybody would be looking at them. So how do we call that married couple? we call them in one word. They are vedēji. Vedēji. And literally it means people who take you by the hand and show you the way and show you good example how to go through difficult times if you wish. And that's the role of that couple. What's interesting about Latvian traditions is that the married woman would walk by her husband's right arm. So when the bride walks down the aisle, she would be on her groom's left side. However, when they are announced married, when they walk out of the church, the bride would turn around and she would be immediately at her newly wedded husband's right arm. So that's how they would walk out of the church. But more about the Latvian words that we use in this ceremony. So a bride is līgava, līgava, and a groom is līgavainis, līgavainis. And the wife of the married couple that I told you about would be vedējmāte. She would have that role during the wedding ceremony and during the after party. So once more, it is vedējmāte. And the husband would be vedējtēvs, vedējtēvs. And according to Latvian traditions, the first kiss happens upon the conclusion of the dinner after the ceremony. So after everybody has eaten the appetizers and the main course, and when the dessert is brought out, somebody tries the dessert and shouts out, rūkt, rūkt, which means bitter. And then everybody else would also repeat, rūkt, rūkt. Bitter, bitter. So they would be saying that the dessert is bitter, and they would demand that it is sweetened up by a kiss. So they would ask that the newlyweds kiss in front of everybody. But the newlyweds would say that they don't know how to do it. And then the married couple, vedējtēvs and vedējmāte, would stand up and show how to kiss. And then the newlyweds would repeat that activity and kiss, and everybody would clap. There was also a rumor that Meghan Markle would not wear a veil, although nobody knows what she is going to wear. Well, in Latvia, veil is not worn anymore that often. But when it was, the difference that I noticed was that it would typically not be worn over the bride's face. It would not cover the bride's face. It would just decorate her hair. But there would be a typical decoration, at least some time ago in Latvia, how the veil itself would be decorated. And there is a little plant that is grown inside Latvian homes. Typically, grandmothers would grow them on their windowsills for their granddaughters. For when they get married, they can pick little branches of that plant and decorate their veils with it. The plant is called myrtus in Latin, and in Latvian it is called mirte. Mirte. And I looked up the English translation, which is myrtle, but I don't think that gives you the right idea what the plant looks like. So I've got a picture for you so that you can see that it's a plant with very tiny branches and tiny leaves. So that's it from me now. If you would like to receive the outline, the notes about this presentation that I gave to you about Latvian weddings, please request it by clicking the link in the description of this video. And please, if you haven't done it yet, subscribe to my YouTube channel in order to get notified about new videos that I'm releasing. But now I'll say bye-bye. Till the next time.